For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008 8 from your Sample Files folder. In Lesson 4-9, you learned how to apply cell styles. You applied the Note style to cell A23. To do that, you selected cell A23 and then clicked Home on the ribbon and in the Styles group, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery. You then click the Note style to apply the note style to cell A23. Let's bring up the Cell Styles gallery again, and notice that Excel 2013 has a large number of predefined cell styles, grouped into good, bad, and neutral, to mark particularly good or bad results, data and model, usually used in a worksheet containing formulas to mark cells that require user input or contain formula results, titles and headings for section titles and column headers, themed cell styles to color cells based upon the theme colors, and number format to quickly apply number formats. For example, the comma zero style will apply the same comma style that you used in Lesson 4-3, but with zero decimal places. As well as the built-in styles, it's possible to define your own custom styles. Custom styles are only available in the workbook in which they were originally created. In order to use them in another workbook, you need to use Excel's Merge Styles feature, and we're going to cover that in the next lesson. Let's begin this lesson by modifying the note style. So I'll click Home tab on the ribbon, and in the Styles group, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery again. Then I'll right-click on the note style and select Modify from the shortcut menu. Next, I'll click the Format button and then the Fill tab on the Format Cells dialog. I'm going to change the background color from yellow to green, so I'll select a light shade of green and click OK and OK again. And you can see that the background color of cell A23 has now changed to green. You should also realize that any other cell on this worksheet that used the note style would also have changed to green at this stage. Let's look again now at the Cell Styles gallery, and notice that the note style is now green. I'm now going to duplicate the green note style to create a custom style. So I'll right-click on the note style and then select Duplicate from the shortcut menu. Now you might expect me to call this style Green Note, but I'm going to call it Blue Note, because I'm going to change the colour in a moment. I click OK, and if we look at the Cell Styles gallery again, you can see that the Green Note style has now been duplicated into a new custom style called Blue Note. Let's change that Blue Note style now so that it really is blue. So I'll right-click on my new custom style, select Modify from the shortcut menu, then the Format button again, and on the Fill tab, I'll click the light blue colour. I click OK and OK again, and you can see that in the Cell Styles gallery, I now have my Blue Note displaying in blue. Let's apply that Blue Note style to cell A23. So I'll click in cell A23 to make it the active cell, and in the Cell Styles gallery, I'll click Blue Note to apply the Blue Note style. Well, you might think that was a very long-winded way of creating a custom style. And of course, there's a much easier way by creating a custom cell style by example. I'm going to now change the background colour of cell A23 to demonstrate how I can create a custom style by example. So I select cell A23, so that's Home tab on the ribbon, and in the Font group, the right-hand side of the Fill Color Split button. and I'll select a light gold colour. Now I'm going to create that custom style by example. To do that, I bring up the Cell Styles gallery and click the New Cell Style link at the bottom left of the gallery. Notice the words By Example within the dialog. That means that any formatting currently applied to cell A23 will be reflected in the new style. And I'll call this style Gold Note and click OK. And when I click the Cell Styles Gallery button again, you can see my two custom styles, the Blue Note and the Gold Note style. I think I'll apply the Gold Note style to cell A23. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008-09. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed lesson 413, Create Your Own Custom Cell Styles.